Here in my hand, I have a little USB stick. And this USB stick contains the distro that I created last night. And I spoke about it in my Amiga OS video that I really wanted to create a train simulator OS. I know, crazy. You know, we also have this Kodi Media Center. It's in effect a bootable USB stick, and then, you know, Kodi will boot up and you will have Kodi. So I wanted to make something like that, but then with the train simulator, the BVA, open BVA train simulator that we have in Linux. It's amazing, it's a great game, and I even added routes. I have a route from 261 kilometers long with all these stations. I have Bulgaria, I have the USA, and even some more cities. Various trains I inserted into the distro, into the game, and in fact I created a distro from it, and here it is. So let's go test it and see if it's any good. Train Simulator OS was created on the Compaq C700. In fact, I continued the work on the Amiga OS, and from there so if you download the ISO file and you create a bootable USB stick, make sure that the USB stick is well formatted. If you already had some other Linux onto it, make sure that you first, you know, format the drive, because you might run into some crazy kernel error. So I inserted the stick. There it is. Okay. And we're gonna boot up the machine. This machine needs a little F12 to bring you into the boot menu. And now we're gonna boot from the stick. Here you can see Open BVA Train Simulator OS 2019. So let's boot it up. Just hit a little enter. Look at the stick. The stick is flashing. Whenever the stick is flashing. And there we go. Train Simulator OS is booting up. And this train we also have in the train simulator, so that's why I use this as the boot splash, to say it this way, boot screen, boot page, however you want to call it. And we're gonna boot into the OS and just look at what's gonna happen. It's booting up, boom. Still booting, and there you go. And as you can see, immediately you will have the BVA simulator that will boot up automatically. So now I want you to go to recently used. Up here you're gonna find various trains, routes. These are routes. Let me bring you a little bit closer. There it is. Okay. And if you click on recently used, you will find some train classes. If you're gonna hit browse manually, you're gonna see two little dots that you can click, and then up here you're gonna see trains. Okay, and these are the trains that are in here. Okay, and my favorite train, in fact, let me see, that is the BR class 323. That is a very nice train. And here we have several routes. We could go for, if you go ahead and browse manually, the two little dots, you're gonna see Desert Freight, Fegüara, Celepitefar, whatever that is. This is a very big one. The 29 to 30, the MAF 29 to 30, it's a route from 200 and something kilometers, really long route. And Superfia, I think that is Brazil as well. We have some routes here. Ramal Saracurana. Let's just grab one. And here you can see it. Here we just loaded it. And
You can also go to the options, but it's already full screen on here, so I'm just gonna hit start the game. And start the game is here. Oh, you cannot see that. Here. You see that? Here you're gonna start the game. Just hit it, and then it's gonna boot up the simulator with the choices that you just made. And this is world's only OpenBV unofficial distribution. It's all about train simulation in this distribution. And we're loading the train. We're doing this straight from off USB. Yeah? So, effect, this is a train simulator. I think world's only train simulator that you can run live from USB. Okay, so let's hit some. We must wait for the stoplight. When you hear psst, then you're there. People are still getting into the train. Takes a while before you can start with driving. Now we can go. So there we go. The F is forward, and the V is the V on the keyboard. You see that? So you must study the keys to get this train going. Okay. And there we go. As you can see, a full screen. Nice 3D cockpit. Don't go too fast. Keep an eye on the speed. This train can take turns with 40, 45, really easy. And there is a station, I think. Oh no. And here is the station. Oh, I passed just a little bit. Nou ja, moet kunnen. And there we go. Even graffiti on the wall. You see that? The graffiti? I think this is Brazil. This is really nice. And those that love train simulation will love it. Okay. This is, in fact, my first build. And I want to make a new build. Because, in fact, I created this test version last night. And I'm gonna add some more routes, because the distro is about 3500 megabytes. So that means that I can add some more roots. Okay, so let's escape. Let's quit the game. Yes, and let me show you the desktop. In fact, this is the desktop, and I don't know what happened here, but this had to be different. This must be like this, and it should be like this. You see that? This is how the desktop should look. So you must resize the icon a little bit. This is the way I made it. I don't know why it's all small. And you see no taskbar, but the taskbar is here at the side. You see that? And by hitting the little train, you can see it saying Lindroid Train Simulator OS. If you hit the little train, then in fact you have a normal Linux with a browser built in, but in fact very light. I have Wine installed as well, so you can also run Windows applications if you wish in this Train Simulator OS, so you could install some Windows games. In the internet you still have a browser and you have transmission to download something. In Office, I removed the Office package, sound and video, simple screen recorder, and of course Rhythmbox. Simple screen recorder if you want to make videos of your train simulator. Remember that if you're gonna run it from USB and you want to record, then you need another USB stick to record too. You understand? So you can copy the recording to that USB stick. So it's a minimalistic Ubuntu, even though it's kind of big, but that's because of the train simulator. Some of these roots, one of the roots is 700 and something megabytes, so it's kind of big. Okay, QMO and Alien are installed, so be my guest if you gonna install this and you want to as well run Android. Just go ahead and type the lines in the command line and go ahead and up here you also see that we have System Back installed, so you will also need this to install the system. Okay, and for those that don't know, then yeah, if you don't know, then probably you are new in this project, then please go ahead and just do a search for Lindroid on YouTube and you're gonna find the videos as well where I show how to install this these kinds of distros that I create. They are all the same way, same way how to install them. It's different than some Ubuntu distribution or even Linux Mint, because you will have to create the partitions yourself and the swap file, but in fact very very easy, and the installing will be performed under 5 minutes. So yeah, if you want this on a computer because you love the train simulation, be my guest, install it, share it with your friends, and after I finished the actual build that I'm gonna share, then yeah, you're gonna get the distro. So leave this video a thumbs up, okay? Leave it a like if you like this project, okay? Because this is in fact world's only a train simulator OS or Linux distribution with train simulator built in, okay? So yeah, thumbs up to the OpenBV community, all the real roots creators. It's a whole lot of work to create a root. Thank you so much for that. You know, if your works are represented in here, or if you're from OpenBV, feel free to download the distro and share it on your website. As long as you're not gonna share it with some Surfy and things like that. But OpenBV people are not like that. Whenever you download a root, it's a straight up download, click and download. So yeah, be my guest. Put the distro on your site, share it, make videos about it. And yeah, if you know even cooler roots, to insert in the OpenBV, let me know. I will surely do that then. And yeah, then we can also say, hey, we have amazing, here's the train that you also see. We have an amazing build of Linux that you can run straight from USB. And you will always have your train simulator with you. This should run on each and every machine out there. Okay. Or maybe if the machine is too old or has real special hardware, probably that won't work. This is 32-bit, so this should also work on 64-bit systems. However, if you have some UEFI bias, then probably, yeah, it's not gonna work. This is another train, and also a nice train. It takes a while before you can leave, and yeah, you have to do all sorts of things. In fact, yeah, I don't know this train too good yet, so I'm still as well learning about these trains. I think somebody is... We should be leaving every minute from now. You hear that? There we go. We had to wait for the whistle. And this is a nice train, guys. This train goes really fast. It's amazing. Amazing, lovely, lovely train. Unknown caller. So I have a call. I'll be right back. I'm back. So where were we? Yeah, we had a little call and I don't know what happened here. Probably I was driving too fast or so, I don't know. In fact, I don't know how to drive this train. So sometimes it takes a while before I get it going. I'm pressing some buttons here. I don't even know what I'm pressing because I don't know this train, okay? You can also connect the joystick and then I never drive this train. I hate this train. I have ATS run. Probably I was driving too fast. And then you get ATS run. And I have no idea what that is. But this is world's first train simulator Linux. Yeah, with Android built-in possibilities. This is Android ready. Okay, this distribution, this Lindroid OS train, or this Lindroid train simulator OS is Android ready. Okay, so yeah, that's it. I hope you kind of like it. I don't like it as usual. I love it. I adore it because, tja, now I can drive my train for hours, eh? Yeah, man. So yeah, probably the next will be Flight Simulator OS. Mm-hmm. And you can see that you can do everything still with this operating system. You can go on the internet, you can play music, you can listen to the radio, you know. Because I left, I think, your radio player in here. Let me see where it is. Sound and video. You see that rhythm box is not removed. It's still in here and it contains a huge list of radio stations, as you already know. And yeah. Thanks to that, you will be able to as well listen to music while, yeah, this thing is not connected to the internet, but while playing your games, you can listen to the music. You can go on the internet to go to YouTube. And yeah, this is a normal PC. However, when you're gonna boot it, it will not bring you into the desktop environment. It will immediately start up the simulator. And in fact, the only thing that I still have to do in the build that you're gonna get is a startup sound. You will hear the train, you know, something like that. That was gonna be the startup sound of this distro. And yeah, congratulations. It's been created. The, yeah, what is it called again? The OpenBVE unofficial Linux distribution.
Now some of you might be like, but hey, we could also install Ubuntu ourselves and then, you know, install BVA ourselves. You could. But if you check on YouTube, you will find out that there is no video showing OpenBVA on an LTS version 2019 Linux, fully updated, you know, with all these. You know, installing these roots is not simple. Installing roots is not simple. You know, installing trains. If you don't know how to do it, you will not be able to do it. You understand? So probably I'm gonna make a video for those that also want to try Train Simulator on their Ubuntu system or Linux Mint system. Just try it, try to install it and tell me what's gonna happen. You know, you're clicking an icon, but the thing is not starting. It's not working, you see? And I got it all working here in this distribution, including extra roots. And the next version that I'm gonna make will probably be done from out a very light installation of Ubuntu. You know, you can also create a bootable Ubuntu installer, ISO, bootable USB stick, that won't have no Firefox, it won't have, you know, nothing. You will have to install all these things yourself. And I think, you know, in my V3, I'm gonna, you know, do that. I'm gonna build, you know, the train simulator on a Ubuntu that is light already, so we can make even more roots. So when the thing becomes 3 gigabytes, the ISO file, you know, we will have a bunch of, you know, even more roots than we have now. But for now, you already have hours and hours of driving pleasure in this distribution, and you can run it straight from USB. Of course, you can as well install it. You know, this is just amazing. So all credits to the OpenBVE team, to all the railroad creators. It's a whole lot of work, really. This is hours, weeks, sometimes months of work. So all credits to the BVE, OpenBVE, and the complete developers team there that are making these railroads, these trains. You guys, thumbs up to you. Thank you very much. This distribution is as well from you. Please, you know, be my guest. Take it, put it on your website, you know, create bootable USB sticks for other people. You know, it's all good. Only thing, when you're gonna share it, you know, share it via my link or share it via your Google link. You can copy the file to your folder, you know, the ISO, so you also have your link, or put it on Mega, I think it's called Mega Upload or so, can't remember, Mega, this Mega site, put it there, you know. But in no way you should put some Surfy or something to it, because if you're gonna do that, that's against my intentions. It's not what I want. I want it to be free for everybody to use, you know, free to share, and free to have. This is it. Good luck, and let me know in the comments if this was good idea, or if you think, hey, sha, or you just take it for granted. It's all good. See you in the next video, and then we talk again. Bye-bye.